Hello, this is Lars Pinne from SUSE and Thomas Kramer from B1 Systems. In this session, we will talk about SUSE HA for SAP HANA with emphasis on things that can happen or that will happen in the real world. And we will have a demo. Demo will be conducted by Thomas, and I will give you an introduction and point to some hopefully interesting and important points from the structure. We will have an overview on best practices for planning and setting up a SUSE HA for HANA. We will point you to some places where to look for information in case something went wrong. And then we will come to a demo on a HANA cluster. We have defined, or SUSE has defined, a set of setups that are known to work, and these setups or use cases or scenarios are described on our website with documentation. Of course, there are some more scenarios, but as rule of thumb, you should follow the documented setups, and then basically it will work. The most common setup is by using two sites. Sometimes it's two data centers or two availability zones in cloud. Sometimes you have a third site, but in general, the application always is clustered across two sites. So this is the most common scenario. And in that case, we can have two or sometimes three SPD devices, which is something Thomas will show later on. In the past, it has turned out that some things you should avoid. And of course, there are some things you should do. Among the things you should avoid is you should not have a cluster without Stornet at all. In fact, it is not supported by SUSE. If you run a cluster on a physical environment, then you should take care for the correct multipath configuration. This also is important for timings. This is something Thomas will come back later on. And since the watchdog has a central role in our concept, no other software than the cluster should use the watchdog. And very important, whatever you want to do, you should have a test for that, and you should test before you go live whether the cluster works as expected. And this comes to the things you should do. It's good to have different communication links for the cluster communication. For example, you should have two cluster communication links. You should have as much SPD devices as possible. You should adapt the timings of the cluster to the environment. Thomas will show you some details on that. And you should set up the cluster step by step. And you should test the cluster step by step. That means if something does not work in the beginning, you should not expect it to work on the end. Special with the pacemaker cluster is if you do a manual resource takeover, you have to clean up the cluster information base later on. This is really special with this cluster product. And of course, since the cluster basically works with timeouts, you should respect the timeouts. That means you should know how long an action will take, and then you should wait until the cluster has done its job. Among the most common reasons for support requests is being not patient enough and confusing the cluster. Later on in the demo, we will see in real life what this means. And of course, I already mentioned that you should define and perform tests for all scenarios the cluster should cover, and you should define and perform tests for the maintenance operations you want to do with the cluster. So, some details where to look for. We have a set of configuration files. Some are basic operating system configuration files, not really cluster specific, but the operating system has to be set up in a proper way. Again, Thomas will show you some points where to look for. And then we have some cluster specific configuration files. In fact, The whole cluster is controlled on operating system level by a handful of three or four files in the file system. If these files are there and if they are set up correctly, then the cluster will start and work, and then you can work with the cluster. And we are talking about HANA. So HANA, the application HANA, needs some specific configuration files, of course. And this is something you have to keep in mind. This is maybe one interesting part. With application clusters or with operating system clusters that control applications, it's always good if the operation system team, the Linux team, and the SAP team knows each other and works together. And therefore, even if you are the Linux team, you should know where to look for the HANA configuration, and you should have an idea how HANA behaves. And of course, you have log files, lots of log files in this case. Sometimes it's a little bit annoying to find information. As a starting point, you always should look into the messages file. Then we have a cluster log file. The cluster writes files for each transition it plans, and it performs into a directory. So for each cluster transition, there is one policy engine file. If you enable the resource agent tracing, then you will have a directory with trace files from the resource agents. And at the end, also the HANA has its own trace files. Sometimes it's worth taking a look into the HANA files. We have a set of commands you can use to check your installation, to check the operating system, to check the cluster, and to check the HANA. First of all, if you do not have a cluster up and running, you can get at least an overview on the HANA and on the operating system. For example, we have a tool to check the operating system log files for common error patterns. If you have lots of multipassing errors in your messages file, you should look at that. And there are a lot of SAP or HANA specific commands. It's good to have an idea about that, but we have some helper scripts to put together information on HANA. Thomas will show this show HANA info script later on. From the HANA perspective, there are some commands you can use. Two very important are the landscape host configuration script and the system replication script. In fact, these two scripts are also used by the cluster resource agent to check the HANA. You should look at that from time to time. The interesting point here is the return code of SAP commands usually is, in good case, different from zero. So unlike Unix, where zero means good, in the SAP world, zero always is the worst case. For the host configuration, the return code 4 is the best you can expect, and for the system replication, 15 is the best. A little bit strange, but it is what it is. And once you have set up the cluster and put the HANA onto the cluster control, you have the usual cluster command crm on crm configure show. The CS cluster state is part of the cluster tools 2 package. These three commands are always first choice to check if the cluster is healthy. If you want to do something with the cluster, you should run these three commands to check if the cluster is ready to take action. And then in this case with the HANA cluster, you have SAP HANA SR show attributes to show how the cluster sees the HANA, and everything should be fine before you start something with the cluster. This is something we'll see later on again. And if you're in charge of troubleshooting or debugging the cluster, we have some tools to do that offline. Basically, you can look into support config archives or into CRM report archives. There is some tools, and most important, or most helpful, is the SAP HANA SR replay archive that helps you to analyze step by step the pEngine files to show in what state the cluster and the HANA is before and step and after. And so you should know these commands. That's it from the overview or theory part. And in a few seconds, Thomas will show you the demo. And I want to do a short wrap up for you. So HANA system replication is not the easiest one to cluster. And at the moment, we are talking about scale up. But even for scale, or for scaleout is even more true. It's getting to be complex, and the topology of the cluster and the structure of the cluster and the fencing resources, particularly SPD, defines how well the cluster can overcome certain situations. You need an understanding not only of the cluster, but also of the resource that has to be controlled by the cluster. You should document what you want to do, and you should always have a plan to check the cluster before going live and to document what you have done. And in case something is unclear, of course, there is help available by SUSE or by partners. So now we can come to the demo performed by Thomas. Thank you.
Right. Now we finally arrived at the demo part of today's session. As you can see here, we have a screenshot of a SAP HANA system replication scale-up cluster with two nodes, HANA 1 and HANA 02. Both nodes are online. We have two IP addresses configured in this case, because the second IP is for the passive side. And with this configuration, you can also read from the passive database side. Of course, you can't write to it, but at least you can read to it. And this is why it's called read enabled. And as you might spot, we have two SPD resources configured. We're talking about this in a couple of minutes again. And let's begin with our cluster consensus manager. As always, this is CoreSync. The timeouts that are configured are the standard timeouts that come out of the box. Nothing changed here. Of course, we have to be as close as possible to a productive setup to communication rings with our two nodes configured here. And of course, we tell CoreSync that it's a two node cluster, and we want CoreSync to be able to run with one node if we start the cluster from scratch. Otherwise, no resources would start, because for that, both nodes would have to be online. And in this case, we don't want that. Right, now let's have a look at HANA. This is, of course, the application the whole thing is about. And there is a nice little tool in the package cluster tools 2, which is called CS underscore show underscore HANA underscore info. And it basically lists all the relevant information we want to know about HANA. So we've got the host name we're on. We've got the SID and the instance number and the user. And then we use subcontrol to get a list of all our services. And as you can see, everything is nice and shiny. Everything is green and running. The system replication that our cluster manages is also up and running. And when we have a look at our setup with HANA tools like HDB and SUtil or landscape host configuration .py, then we can see too that both instances are online and in sync, and all our processes are up and running. Right, then let's move on to the cluster configuration itself. Right, as usual, we've got our nodes at the top of the configuration, plus As it is a HANA system replication cluster with quite a lot of attributes, the rule of thumb is that the node that has the big number as a last primary time, that's the active side, and one that has the 30 is the passive side. That one's over here. And we have configured the reader access for the passive side. You might not have seen that before. And as I mentioned before, in this case, we've got two SPD resources with a different PCMK delay base. That basically means that in our normal operation, we want to be HANA 01, the primary side. And if we lose connection between our two nodes, then this will make sure that HANA 02 is fenced first. So that means that the application doesn't have any downtime. And this is, of course, a good thing to have. Right. The rest is pretty much standard, apart from our second rule for the IP address for the secondary site. And what is noteworthy is automated register. The default or the value to begin with is normally false, but as we have quite a fully automated cluster here, we've switched this to true so that the takeover and the register is done automatically without any interference of an operator. And the last but very important thing to mention is the SAP HANA SR hook, which you can see here. This is a new thing in a scale-up cluster. Usually we had that in a scale-out cluster. This is the first bit of the configuration, and here is the second bit. I'll show you the third bit in a second. This is very important if we have two networks, and Corosync talks across a different wire than the HANA system replication. And there are some corner cases when the replication breaks, and HANA knows that, but Corosync doesn't notice that, of course, because it's on a different network. And if there is that interruption on the system replication network, then HANA will know that first. And this is the way for HANA to tell the cluster that something is wrong, and then Pacemaker can react instantly. All right, and the third bit that belongs to this hook is a short rule for our sudoers file. Right. Now, let's have our CRMmon cluster status output once again. And what we're going to do now is a failover between from HANA 1 to HANA 02, so basically from one data center to the other. And of course, we have to switch the HANA role then. So what I'm going to do now is to switch off the virtual machine that is HANA 01, and this is it done now. And in the meantime, I'm going to tell you a few things about SPD. So, of course, this is nonsense. Apart from the fact that we have three SPD devices, which is good for production, everything else is not as good. One SPD device is actually a very bad thing because there is a single point of failure. But the important bit, of course, is always in our pacemaker cluster is the thing about timeouts. So the first rule of thumb, if we have a look at our first relevant timeout, which is the watchdog timeout, is that it should be longer than anything that can fail storage-wise below it. That means SCSI timeouts, multipath timeouts, and so on. And the second one should be around about twice as long as that first timeout. This is, if you want, to the SPD loop. Okay, I'm still waiting for this node to disappear because this can't happen because I've put some security in there. And now I can. I've killed, of course, the shell I'm on, so I have to move on to HANA 02 and show you the devices again. And when we have a look at the cluster, it says unclean and offline for HANA 01. And now we have to wait for the actually the second SPD timeout I've showed you to finish, and then this node will turn into a proper offline and the unclean will disappear. And then we should see the failover of HANA and the promoting to primary again. And this is, of course, what this cluster is all about. First of all, to keep the service up. And then, of course, once this is done, to reinstate the system replication once the second node is back online again. So now it's promoting this half of the database resource as we expect, of course. And in the meantime, I can start my virtual machine again. Of course, we have disabled the cluster auto start. This is always a good thing to do because you do not want to have corner cases when a node joins the cluster, is fenced again, and reboots, joins the cluster again, and is fenced over and over again. And of course, you want to check whether something is broken, what has actually killed this node. And you want to check this, of course, in both nodes. Right, now the database is reachable and online and writable again. And now we are going to start pacemaker again, but before that we are going to check the status of HANA. And as we can expect, because the cluster says everything is fine, our processes are up and running, and the site that is still live is primary. Of course, there is no secondary system yet. That means that the system replication, of course, is not up and running at the moment. And this is what we are going to reinstate now. And the only thing I have to do is to start the cluster service again, and then the rest is managed by Pacemaker and its resource agents. And now we can see the secondary database start, and this will take a few seconds, and then we can check the status of HANA with HANA means again, and then we will see that everything has worked and is fine again. Just a couple of seconds more until the starting has disappeared and has turned into slave. Right, we can have a look at this again. And we see that there is a secondary attached now. Now we are still waiting for the replication, which is in sync now. Let's do this again and check for the cluster. The cluster says it's fine. And let's have a look at the application once again. Now, the system replication is up and running, and the two instances are, as we can see below here, in sync. So the cluster and HANA think the same, and this is a good thing. And we can also check if the cluster is still operating something, but the cluster has the status of s underscore idle. That means that it's basically sitting around at the moment. There are no operations pending, and it's just doing its regular monitoring work. Right. That was basically it. If you have any questions, you're of course always welcome to drop either Lars or myself an email. We will be happy to answer them. And thank you for listening, and I wish you wherever you are a nice day or a good night. Thank you very much.